May God bless you all day. Ask God's pardon for all our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Direct your faithful Lord in the way of eternal salvation, which the Bishop Saint Apollinaris showed by his teaching and martyrdom, and grant through his intercession that we may so persevere in keeping your commandments as to merit being crowned with you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Hear what the Lord says. Arise, present your plea before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear, O mountains, the plea of the Lord. Pay attention, O foundations of the earth. For the Lord has angry against his people, and he enters into trial with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you? Or how have I wearied you? Answer me. For I brought you up from the land of Egypt, from the place of slavery I released you, and sent before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. With what shall I come before the Lord? Bow before God with honor. Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with myriads, streams of oil? Shall I get my firstborn for my crime, and the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? You have been told, O man, what is good, and what the Lord requires of you, only to do right and to love goodness and to walk humbly with your God, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
When you do these things, shall I be deaf to you? Or do you think I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing you before them. I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me. And to him who goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Worship in the world.
Saint Apollinaris, pray for us.
For all our beloved dead, that they may join the saints and angels in the heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord. For Henry and Phyllis Hendrickson, for whom this Mass is offered, for all those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord. God of love and goodness, these are the prayers offered before you. Answer us according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Lord, wash my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Sanctify your offerings by your blessing, O Lord, we pray. And by your grace, may we be set afire with that flame of your love, through which Saint Apollinaris overcame every bodily torment, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess our resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. May the sacred mysteries of which we have partaken, O Lord, we pray, give us that determination which made your beloved martyr Apollinaris faithful in your service and victorious in suffering, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.